So isotretinoin is a retinoid, so it's a vitamin A that has been used since 1982. It's an amazingly effective drug, but a very controversial drug. I mean, it's had a very turbulent history. But I can't imagine practicing dermatology without Accutane. And it's approved for people with severe nodular cystic acne, or for individuals who even have much milder acne, but it's very impactful on their lives. And I think that the trend has been to use it earlier rather than later, certainly without realization that a high percentage of people will have patients, teens will have scarring. And the sooner we turn off the acne, the better. Now, the controversial aspects of this drug are, number one, I think, is that it's teratogenic. You girls can't get pregnant on it because it causes all these horrible fetal abnormalities. But it's out of the system very quickly. So 1 month after you're off the drug, you can get pregnant quite safely. So this issue about contraception and avoiding pregnancy is a huge and obviously very important issue. Other things that have caused controversy is depression and Accutane. And there have been a number of studies, especially recently from Sweden and Italy, suggesting that there may not actually be a very strong link at all with depression and acne. My own suspicion is that it's idiosyncratic. I think that for a small number of individuals, it may be a brain irritant. They get very black, very down on it. But that reverses almost as soon as you bring them off the drug. So this question about depression, suicide, I think we just have to be observant and make people aware that it would be, if there's any truth to it at all, that's a rare idiosyncratic event, probably. Most recently, we've had this issue of class action suits in the United States about Accutane and inflammatory bowel disease. And there is different viewpoints on this. Most of the studies show no connection between Accutane and inflammatory bowel disease. There's another study that shows that maybe ulcerative colitis, there may be a slight increased risk of inflammatory bowel disease with Accutane. Most of the studies, though, show that the incidence of inflammatory bowel disease in people with Accutane is not very different from those not on Accutane. So I think that the reality is that the risk, if it's a risk at all, is very small. And if you're on the drug and you have, you know, cramping, bloody diarrhea, have problems, you clearly just stop the medication. It has revolutionized the treatment of this drug, and there are very few drugs in the world of medicine that cure anything. Accutane is one of them, and there's nothing more pleasing than to see the teenager with significant acne, see with the start of Accutane, their heads are down, and they're uncommunicative, and with time they sit up straighter and they look you in the eye, and has a life-changing effect. So it's a powerful drug that has to be dealt with caution. You have to monitor it very closely. You have to follow the blood work on it. We mainly check for the fats, the lipids. Rarely does it ever irritate the liver, although we have to monitor that. It's an extraordinary drug.